That's My Life. Brought to you by Allstate, whose policies now include protection for your home, your family, as well as your car. You're in good hands with Allstate. And now, let's all play What's My Line?
And now let's meet our award-winning panel of What's My Line. First, the delightful star of stage and television, Miss Arlene Francis.
And now an exceedingly charming man who has made the Broadway musical The Happiest Girl in the World, The Happiest Show in the World, our own Captain Hook, Cyril Richard.
And now a lady who needs no introduction whatsoever and for whom I have the greatest respect and admiration, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. And now I'd like to introduce a gentleman on my left whose syndicated column is sent out all over the country by King Features Syndicate, Bennett Cerf.
It was a very big week for our panel moderator this week because he was one of the top newsmen in on the triumph of the astronaut the other day. And he also picked the winner of the Derby right on the nose. And he's so triumphant about that, he's a little hoarse himself tonight. Mr. John Charles Daly.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
I didn't think he dared, but he did.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to What's My Line. It's nice to have Mr. Richard with us.
Thank you.
And I'm... must say that that's probably the last kind thing you'll hear for the next 30 minutes, sir, only because of the company you keep. We're so intent upon giving Arlene and Dorothy and Bennett a hard time that you get caught up in the toils of it, too. We'll also have a famous mystery guest before the panel a little bit later in the program, and we'll meet our first challenger after this word from Ed Reimer's speaking.
And now let's meet our first...
Now let's meet our first contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please?
George Koch. Is that right, sir? Mr. Koch, where are you from?
Chester, Pennsylvania.
Chester, Pennsylvania. Well, it's nice to have you with us. May I present the panel, Koch? Will you join me over here, sir? Do you know how we keep score on What's My Line?
I think so, sir.
All right, then let's let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. Panel, we can tell you that Mr. Koch is salaried and he deals in a service, and we'll begin the general questioning with Dorothy Kilgallen.
Mr. Koch, do you have anything to do with outer space?
No.
Small conference. We feel here, Dorothy, because this covers such a broad area that we don't want to be charged subsequently, you know, with misleading the panel, having anything to do with outer space. Now, this could, you know, take in the whole area of communications, the machining of vehicles, et cetera, et cetera. In that broad context, we'll have to give you a qualified yes.
Do you work chiefly on the ground, Mr. Koch?
No.
That's one down and nine to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Koch, did you play any part whatever in the recent launching of our astronaut?
Yes.
But you did not do it on the ground, Mr. Koch. Did you have anything to do with picking him up after he had landed in the sea?
Yes.
Were you with in the helicopter that picked him up?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Miss Brent.
You had nothing to do with the helicopter that picked him up. And I can rule out the carrier. You weren't associated in any way with the carrier at sea that he went to.
Is that
That was one of those double, triple, quadruple negatives, and you just give her yes, you were, and the answer is no, so that's three down and seven to go. Mr. Richard?
Then, Mr. Koch, you were on the carrier.
Yes.
You wouldn't be the captain of the carrier,
no.
Would you?
The captain of the carrier. Four down and six to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Well, did you talk to him after he got aboard?
Yes.
Do you have any title besides Mr.?
Yes.
Are you a doctor?
No.
Five down and five to go, Mr. Sir.
Are you an officer in the United States Armed Forces, sir?
Yes.
Would it be in the Marines?
No.
Six down and four to go, Mr. Sir.
Are you a commander?
No.
Seven down and three to go, Mr. Richard.
Are you a reporter?
No.
Eight down and two to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Well, are you with the Navy?
Yes.
You're not the captain.
Admiral.
The ship. Are you an admiral?
Yes.
Oh! Well, we were shooting too low, weren't we? Well, it must have been a thrilling moment.
That is.
Well, have we got it? Is there more?
Admiral Koch of the,
Right. Commanding officer of Task Force Carrier. It's Carrier Force 18, is it, sir? Yeah, well, we'll throw the cards over. I've got to give it to you, panel. Actually, you reached for it right away, and it was the particularity of Rear Admiral Koch's position that you lost. He is the commander of Carrier Division 18, which was the Lake Champlain and her escorting craft. Yes. Now, if I get off base here, you knock me down quickly. And it was the Admiral's force that did that wonderfully skillful job of being unseen, and I think it was, what, 8 minutes? Less than 8 minutes, sir, when you had the capsule out of the water and back. The
capsule was out in about 4 minutes, and we had the Shepard back on board.
On board in about 8 minutes, and it was one of the great and exciting moments. I know, sir, that you don't need to be told that all of the whole country is very proud of the part that you played with your staff and the crews of your many ships under your command in that exciting moment. We got some sense out of the television and radio transmissions from your carrier division, the excitement that you felt down there. But I think that perhaps the greatest thing was, and I want to get the sequence of it, and you're here so that we can get the sequence. Did Commander Shepard get out of the helicopter and just casually walk over to the capsule to get his space helmet, which he left inside?
He did. That was totally unplanned. The doctor was to keep him away from everybody at first and take him down to the debriefing room, but he wanted to get his helmet out first and make sure that the clock that he wanted to keep for his own was intact.
Oh, that's just great. That's wonderful. I know that the training of the astronauts took a period of 2 years. How much training did you have to do with your recovery division, which it actually was, so that
the destroyers and the carrier that we had was actually about 4 days. The Marines, however, that picked him up, MAG 26, they had been working with the astronauts, and Coons, who actually picked him up, had been working almost 2 years.
With the astronauts?
With the astronauts, yes.
Ah, that's wonderful. Well, speaking through you to the entire United States Navy, I must say, sir, that the part the Navy played in that great day's activities was magnificent, and we all take our caps off to you. I think the Navy term is well done, and it was indeed well done. I might say that Rear Admiral Koch himself was a pilot, or is a pilot, and he was made Rear Admiral last month, and I can't think of a better and happier celebration for him than that he should have commanded the carrier force that played so large a part last Friday morning.